فؤادك الأيام فتى.
Shaykh AbdulRahman Nasir now, rahimahullah, he's talking about the 13th line. فَإِن تَزَاحَمَ عَدَدُ الْمَصَالِحِ يُقَدَّمُ الْأَعْلَى مِنَ الْمَصَالِحِ. This qa'ida is تَزَاحُمُ الْمَصَالِحِ. تَزَاحُمُ الْمَصَالِحِ means that the good and the benefits are now it is coming into contradiction with another maslaha. So you have two goods which you're going to have to do one of them. And there's no way to leave any one of them, because you don't want to go to a mafsada. There's either, you have two masalih, two goods that are in front of you. The Shaykh is saying, فَإِن تَزَاحَمَ عَدَدُ الْمَصَالِحِ. If that happens, they are in تَزَاحُمْ يُقَدَّمُ الْأَعْلَى مِنَ الْمَصَالِحِ. You're going to then give precedence to which one? The maslaha which is high. The maslaha that is greater is the one that's taken. Ah. And this, inshaAllah ta'ala, this chapter, I mean this point, a lot of people are heedless about it. فَيُضِلُّونَ وَيُضِلُّونَ. They become misguided of it and they misguide others because of it. So it's important that this point, this qa'idah, a person has to solidify on him on this issue. And he has good understanding of it. And that he understands how to weigh between two goods and that are running besides one another, that you're going to have to take one of them anyways. You have to choose which of the two is higher. And the author, rahimahullah, he mentions this. And this he mentions is a qa'idatun muqarraratun bi'adadin min al-ayat wal-ahadith. Many verses and ahadith actually affirm this qa'ida. From them is Surah Al-Zumar, Ayah 55. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. Allah says, follow the best of what? مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ, that which has been sent to you from your Lord. So Allah uses the word أَحْسَنَ, the best. Because the Qur'an, all of it is good. So within the Qur'an, there is things that may be higher than others. Also, Surah Al-Zumar, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, he said, فَبَشِّرْ عِبَاد, give glad tidings to my servants. الَّذِينَ, the ones, يَسْتَمِعُونَ الْقَوْلَ, they hear the speech. فَيَتَّبِعُونَ, and they follow, أَحْسَنَه, the good of it. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ هَدَاهُمُ اللَّهُ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. They are فيتبعون they follow أحسنة, they follow the best of it. أحسنة صيغة التفضيل. It is the best of it. So the word that keep coming in the first verse that I mentioned, واتبعوا أحسن ما أنزل إليكم من ربكم, and this ayah, فبشر عباد الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنة أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب, shows you this word ahsan. So if tazahum al-masalih, two masalih are running besides one another, the person needs to take the best of those. And there's also another chapter which the fuqaha and the usuliyin, they talk about, which is known as saddu al-dhara'i', which is known as what? Saddu al-dhara'i'. Saddu al-dhara'i', this qa'ida, this principle that we're mentioning today, which is تَزَاحُمُ الْمَصَالِحِ, it falls under سَدُّ الذَّرَائِعِ. You'll find it in that chapter. And you find that the scholars, they talk about التَّرْجِيحُ فِي كُتُوبِهِمُ الْأُصُولِيَّةِ. The books of fiqh, أصول الفقه, they look at how to mention which of the two masalih is higher. How to know, how to identify this maslaha being higher than this maslaha. فيما هو الأعلى من المصالح وما هو الأقل والأدنى, and which of them is the lower and the of the two مصالح. For example, if you look at the actions that are done, we find that the actions are of types. the actions that occur from the creation and the children of Adam, you find that the actions are of types. There are actions yata'adda naf'uhu ila al-ghayr. Its benefits, it transmits to what? To others. It moves to others. Actions in which it's good. It is not exclusive to you, but others also fall under it. And you also find others which are exclusive to you. That's the second type of actions, which is what? Actions which are exclusive to you, and they don't go and move on to others. Now that we've looked at the action in those two types, which are actions that are يَتَعَدَّى نَفْعُهُ إِلَى الْغَيْرِ, and actions which are, so the first action is called أَفْعَال, which are مُتَعَدِّيَةً, and the second one are called أَفْعَال, which are قَاصِرَةً, actions which are exclusive to you alone, like no one else comes into it. This one, which is the قَاصِر, and the other one which is مُتَعَدِّي, when you come to, if there's two maslaha, a maslaha that's exclusive to you, and a maslaha that others have to share with you, which is a maslaha others come into it, the ulama la shak, they say, الفعل المتعدي نفعه إلى الغير أولى من الفعل القاصر. So that qa'ida is how you do the tarjih. That the actions that involves others, that others are going to come into it with you, is better than what? It is better than the action which is exclusive to you. It is better than the action that is exclusive to you. And an example would be for that. A person who, inshallah, we'll bring examples later for it, inshallah. Each one will bring it, don't worry. Or even if we do give an example, the example would be a person who stands up and he prays Qiyamul Layl and he prays voluntary prayers, and another person he spends the whole night teaching. He stands up and he's teaching, educating the people, calling them to the religion of Allah. Which one is better? Here, because there's tazahum al-masalih, that the two maslahas are, there are two maslahas. Qiyamul layl is a maslaha, and teaching and educating the people is a maslaha. Now that those two masalih, tazahum, took place, and you're not able to do both of them, we'll say to you, inshallah ta'ala, that the maslahatul muta'ama, fi'lul muta'addi, the actions that is not exclusive to you, which is when you teach, you're benefiting others, that is better to do it. لذلك, that's why Imam Ahmad, when he was asked, a man, yusalli, wa yasum, a man he fasts, he prays, is he better in your eyes or the one who stands up and refutes the innovators, which one is better for you? Imam Ahmad said, the one who fasts and the one who prays, his good is exclusive to him. Like it's a benefit that is exclusive to him. As for the one who stands up and refutes the innovators, his naf' is what? It's naf' muta'addi. It's ama khair, ama fi'il, which is muta'addiya. It moves on from him to others. And I said this at the beginning, this is a babun yaghfulu anhu kathirun minan nas. A lot of people are heedless of it. And they think that fulan is good. Why? Because he's always praying and he's fasting and he's doing. And the one who stands up and warns against the innovators, the one who stands up, who educates and teaches the people, is seen as what? He is seen as an individual who is not of good. And that is ignorance of the masalih. Now, so that's how we realize. Also, the other one is that, the other second way to do tarjih, to give which of the two masalih that are running besides one another, which of these two shall I give precedence to? For example, you have an action which is obligatory. This action is what? Wajib. And this action is what? Mustahab, is recommended. It's mustahab masnoon, it's a sunnah. Which one gets precedence? Al-fi'lul wajibi awla min al-fi'lil mustahabbil masnoon. The qa'ida is what? A fi'il, an action which is wajib, it is obligatory, it is mandatory, takes precedence over what? The action which is recommended. Or in other wordings, al-fardu afdalu min al-nafli. That the voluntary is the obligatory is better than the voluntary. Or in other words, some scholars, what do they say? La yutrakul wajibu. a obligatory act is not left illa li wajibin mithla, unless another wajib comes. You don't leave a wajib except for another wajib. That's a qa'idah. And this, inshallah, is an issue which we see walil asaf al-shadid. Some people who would come in what? Who will come to the masjid for salatul fajr, and he hasn't prayed the two rak'ah before fajr. The two rak'ah before fajr, which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, rak'atayn qabla al-fajr khayrun min ad-dunya wa ma fiha, or kama qala sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Two voluntary prayers, two units of prayers. They are two units of prayers. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to us, it is better than this dunya and everything that is in it. A person comes to the masjid and he comes late to the masjid. Meaning, he comes and the imam and the people are praying and they're in the salah. So when he comes to the masjid, he finds that the people are already praying. So he comes and he prays the two unit, the two sunnah, and then he catches up with the salah. This is incorrect. This is incorrect. And that goes against what? This qa'idah. Also, the evidence for this qa'idah is that which has Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah narrated. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي بِشَيْءٍ أَحَبَّ إِلَيَّ مِمَّ افْتَرَضْتُهُ عَلَيْهِ. The hadith al-Qudsi. The hadith is a hadith al-Qudsi. That Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says, وَمَا تَقَرَّبَ إِلَيَّ عَبْدِي. My servant does not come close to me in a matter which is more beloved to me than that which I have made obligatory on him. So meaning Allah is saying, the thing that I love the most is that my servant, to get close to me, is to come with a obligatory act. So that's what Allah loves the most. Naam. Also, the other ways to do tarjih bayna al-masalihi, to choose between two maslahas that are running besides each other, is that al-maslahatul khasa, the specific maslaha, takes precedence over what? Ala al-maslahati al-amma, than the general maslaha. Fi mahalli al-khusus, in specific designated places. Wa yu'malu bil maslahati al-amma fi ma'ada. And the maslahatu al-amma is implemented in other places. That's a qa'ida. That was a principle. This qa'ida needs sharah, and it needs explanation. And inshallah ta'ala, with examples, these principles become more clear. For example, we know that the Qur'an is what? Afdal al-dhikr. The Qur'an is what? The Qur'an is the best form of dhikr. The remembrance of Allah. It's the best form. But we find there are times when this act of recitation of the Qur'an, reciting the Qur'an, being a great maslaha, being better than any form of dhikr that a person can do, the Qur'an takes precedence over it. But there are times when no, the dhikr takes precedence over it. Such as what? For example, adhkar al-salawat that are done in the salah. The adhkar that are done after the salah. The adhkar which are done in the sabah. The adhkar that are done in the masa. These take precedence over the Qur'an. These take precedence over the Qur'an. But when these places are not taking place, or you're not in the salah, and you're outside the salah, then the general one, which is the salah, takes precedence over it. So for example, right now, this minute, since we're not in the salah, since right now to read Qur'an or to do dhikr, which is better, la shakka, the reading the Qur'an, it takes precedence over it. That's why I said, inna al-maslahat al-khasati muqaddaman ala al-maslahat al-amma fi mahalli al-khusus. Oh, the qa'idah said this, sorry. The qa'idah said this. Also, one of the ways to distinguish or to do tarjih بين المصالح is what? There's two maslahas running besides one another. Is إن الفضيلة المتعلقة بنفس العبادة أولى من الفضيلة المتعلقة بظرفها. That the virtue that is connected to the act itself takes precedence over the virtue that is connected to either the place or the time. بظرفها means what? أي بظرف الزمان أو المكان. Understand this. The virtue that's connected to the ibadah takes precedence over the virtue that's connected to the place and the time. It'll become clear this way, inshallah ta'ala. Which is, Ar-ramlu. Ramlu means it's not jogging, but it's walking a bit faster. It's a form of jogging. To jog in your tawaf al-qudum. The tawaf al-qudum, when you come to the Kaaba, there are two types of tawaf. Tawaf al-ifada and tawaf al-qudum. When you're doing the tawaf, to jog in the tawaf, it is mustahab. And this istihbab is connected to what? It is connected to the ibadah. Isn't this a virtue that's connected to the ibadah that you can gain? Yes, it is. Muta'alliqatun. It is connected to what? It is connected to bidat al-ibadah. It is connected to the ibadah. And what is the ibadah that is connected to? It's connected to the tawaf itself. Na'am. Also, وَالْقُرْبُ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ. Getting close to the Kaaba. Are you with me? It's also mustahab. It's also what? Mustahab. But what is it connected to? مُتَعَلِّقَةٌ بِالْمَكَانِ. It's connected to the place. So now what about I can't jog if I get close to the Kaaba because it becomes crowded? I'm unable to jog when I go close to the Kaaba. Which of the two do I give precedence to? I give precedence to the one that's connected to the ibadah, not the one that's connected to the place. Good. Also, the ways that the scholars, they give precedence over some masalih over others is, one of the maslaha has multitude of benefits in it, whereas the other one just has a couple of benefits in it. The benefits that are present in this one, the quantity is little. And the benefits in this one, when you looked at it, it has more benefits in it. You give the one that has more benefits in it than the one that has less benefits in it, when you look at the adad and that are in it. If that which I mentioned, inshallah ta'ala, has all become clear to you all, then this qa'idah of the Shaykh rahimahullah ta'ala, this qa'idah of the author rahimahullah ta'ala is, فَإِن تَزَاحَمَ عَدَدُ الْمَصَالِحِ يُقَدَّمُ. You give presents. الْأَعْلَى مِنَ الْمَصَالِحِ. And that was just one or two examples, or a couple of examples of how to do tarjih. But they are what? They are more than that. Another point that I have to also elaborate on, which is, from the masalih are those which are darura, they're necessity. It's necessity. So if we don't do this maslaha, it may result to the ending of a person's life, or losing the happiness of the hereafter. Something might happen. Such as the maslaha to deen, maslaha to nafs, the maslaha of the religion, the maslaha of the person's soul. فهذه مقدمة على المصالح الحاجية. This one takes precedence over the maslaha. So the maslaha is called maslaha al-daruriyah and a maslaha al-hajiyah. Maslaha which is necessity and a maslaha which is I need it, but it's not a necessity. You just need it. نعم. مصلحه الحاجية means الذي إذا قدر فقده أدى ذلك إلى الضيق والحرج. The maslaha al-daruriyah means if it goes, a life would either go or a person would lose their religion. Or maslahatul hajiyya means what? That if the person doesn't gain this maslaha, what will happen is the person will just live a bit of burden, a little hardship will come through to them, but they will still live. And that is important that the person realizes this. And the matters pertaining to al-darura and hajiyat, we will come to it now, inshallah ta'ala. Also, the masalih, there are those who we can say they are maslaha. We can say this is a maslaha, because the Shari'ah قَدْ دَلَّتْ عَلَيْهِ has indicated this. That this is a maslaha. And from the masalih are those which are what? مَا هُوَ ظَنِّيٌ Those which are assumptions. It's based upon striving. It's based upon assuming that it's a maslaha. And which one takes precedence? المصلحه القطعيه مقدمه على الظنيه the one which its maslaha is known it takes precedence over the one that's maslaha is what it's based on assumption speculation نعم also you have to realize as a side benefit inshallah ta'ala which is the قطع that which is قطعي based on certainty ليس على مرتبة واحدة. It's not of one level. And also the assumption is not also of one level. وليس الظن على مرتبة واحدة. The assumption is not also based on all on what? All on one level. Rather, it is of different levels. على مراتب متعددة. وتختلف هذه المراتب. And these levels differ. So within the ظني, there are ترجيح within itself. The stronger it is, then the weaker it is. Also, the maratib which are qat'i, that are known out of necessity, are not of levels. Na'am. The author then goes on to say, وَضِدُّهُ تَزَاحُمُ الْمَفَاسِدِ يُرْتَكَبُ الْأَدْنَى مِنَ الْمَفَاسِدِ This qa'ida is the opposite to the previous mentioned qa'ida, which is تَزَاحُمُ الْمَفَاسِد Before was what? تَزَاحُمُ الْمَصَالِح Which is the opposite. When you have to take on بحيث لا يتمكن المرء A person is unable to leave these harm. They have to do one of these مفسدة. من ترك المفسدتين معا. You are unable to leave. You're going to have to do one مفسدة. Whether it's the higher one or the lower one. You're going to have to do a مفسدة. At this point, But remember, you have to realize, this قاعدة only applies when? بالشرط. It's a condition. The person إنما يتمكن من ترك إحداهما بشرط ارتكاب الأخرى. That if the person will not be able to leave one, and except he's going to fall into the other. But if a person has to wait between مصلحة and مفسدة, then this قاعدة is not talking about it. The قاعدة is talking about there's two مفسدة. You're going to have to fall into one of them anyways. There's no way out of it. At this point, what do you do? At this point, you're going to take the lesser فحينئذ يرتكب المفسدة الأقل من أجل درء المفسدة الأعلى. من أجلي درء المفسدة الأعلى You will fall and you will do the lesser of the two harms So you can push away the greater harm And this قاعدة لها أدلة في الشريعة This قاعدة has evidence in the شريعة For it is من أدلتها From it أدلة From it Is قوله جل وعلا Allah's statement فمن الضر غير باغ ولا عاد فلا إثم عليه This ayah, Allah says, فَمَنِ الضُّرَّ The person who falls under necessity. غَيْرَ بَاغٍ وَلَا عَادٍ Who does not exceed his limits in this regard. فَلَا إِثْمَ عَلَيْهِ There is no harm on him. So a person is in a state of necessity. He is burdened into a matter. Allah says, as long as he doesn't transgress his limits. Like, you need it, you're not allowed to go overboard. You stick to what's your need. You stick to what is your need. Here we have to realize, تعارضت مفسدتان Two harms have presented itself to you نعم And the ayah mentions them One مفسدة is what? تلف النفس Your nafs is going to go That's one مفسدة in the ayah Which is if you don't eat you're going to die And the second one is There's a مفسدة which is أكل الميتة Eating the dead animal That's what the ayah is talking about So in the middle of the desert You're either going to die Or there's a dead animal in front of you Sharia, what did he do? فروعت الأشد تجتنب المفسدة الأشد ولو كان في ذلك ارتكاب المفسدة الأقل The person will remove and get rid of the greater of the two مفسدة which is not to die. He has to get away from that. Even if that means and it results to what? That he eats the animal which is dead. And that's a harm itself. And as we've taken before the 13th qa'idah, when we were talking about the 12th qa'idah, we took that the mafasid, there is what? ما هو محرم, there are those which is haram. وما هو مكروه, and those which are disliked. And from them are, from the haram, are those which are kabair, And from the haram, there are those which are sagair, minor. So when they become, we have to choose between two harams or two mafsada, what do we take? فَنَجْتَرِبُ الصَّغِيرَةِ وَلَوْ فَعَلْنَا الْمَكْرُهِ We will leave the minor sin and we will fall into the makruh, the dislike. وَنَجْتَنِبُ الْكَبِيرَةِ We stay away from the major, وَلَوْ كَانَ فِي ذَلِكَ فِعْلُ لِلصَّغِيرَةِ Even if that means or it entails that we will fall into the minor of the sins. This is when, إِذَا لَمْ يُمْكِنْ تَرْكُ الْجَمِيعِ As long as the person is unable to leave all. If he's able to leave all of the mafsada, then this qa'id is not talking about that. Also, the mafsada are divided into types. مِنَ الْمَفَاسِدِ مَا يَتَعَلَّقُ بِالْغَيْرِ There are mafasid which involves others. وَمِنْهَا مَا هُوَ قَاصِرُ عَلَى النَّفْسِ And there are those who are specific to you. نعم. The mafasid that is attached to you and also others is, for example, if a person, this involves others, it's not you alone, it's you and another person or other people. For example, a person has to eat a dead animal. Or he has to eat, he's got food here. He's got food which is halal, good. And he has a dead animal. And he has a dead animal. You see? And there are two of them. There are two of them. If he takes the halal food, then the other person is going to fall into eating the haram. So he has to take the lesser, he has to take the what? He has to take the lesser of the two mafsada, which is here right now, which is the mafsadatun, the harm that you're going to involve others into, you take the mafsada which is less. Especially if that other person is going to have a harm from the animal which they're going to eat. It's going to cause them it's going to cause their illnesses, harm. You take the dead animal and you eat that and you give the person the animal which will not harm them. The other person is going to be suffering from the animal they eat. Naam. Whereas you won't. It won't, you won't. So I said two people walk in the desert, and there's a dead animal, and there's food which is not dead. This person, if they eat this food, which is the haram one, that it will cause their life to go. Whereas if you eat it, it won't cause you it. So you give them the halal food and you tell them to eat it, and you eat the haram, because it won't cause you any harm. It won't cause you any harm. So this mafsada is what? You're taking the mafsada to a mafsada, which is the mafsada which is muta'alliqatun bil ghayri, and that which is connected to you. Na'am. Also, there are many other examples of how the mafasid give tarjih and how it's chosen over one another. This qa'idah that the Shaykh mentions, other qawa'id will fall under it, such as al-dararu la yuzalu بِالضَّرَرِ أَمَا دَرْءُ الْمَفْسَدَةِ مُقَدَّمٌ عَلَى جَلْبِ الْمَصَالِحِ Which is a evil الضَّرَرُ لَا يُزَالُ بِالضَّرَرِ That a harm is not rebelled with another harm. Or the famous one that the Usuliyin say, and it's the most common one, is دَرْءُ الْمَفَاسِدِ Rebelling a harm takes precedence over bringing good. دَرْءُ الْمَفَاسِدِ Rebelling harm takes precedence over being good. So some people, they think, they look at the good that they're going to bring, but they don't look at the fact that they're going to have to take out. They're going to have to do a haram in order to bring the good. The Sharia wants you to get rid of the haram first before you bring a good. So even if you don't bring a good, it doesn't matter as long as you don't do no mafasid. Naam. This qa'idah, which is adar'ul mafasidi, muqaddamun ala jalb al masalih, how do they get it? Or where does it root from? First of all, it falls under this qa'idah that we're mentioning. But they say that the sharia, once it's observed, the kitab and the sunnah, once it's been looked at, it has been known that the prohibitions that are in the Quran and the sunnah are more greater and they are more in number than the commands that you find in the Qur'an. The manhiyat, the prohibitions, are more concerned by the Sharia than there are in terms of the commands. The Sharia gives more consideration, it gives more thoughts to the prohibitions than it does towards the commands. And the evidence that they used was the hadith narrated by Bukhari and Muslim, and the wording is the wording of Imam Muslim. That the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, مَا نَهَيْتُكُمْ عَنْهُ فَاجْتَنِبُوهُ. Anything which I have prohibited you from, stay away from it. وَمَا أَمَرْتُكُمْ, and anything which I have ordered you, فَأْتُوا, come with it, مَا اسْتَطَعْتُمْ, that which you're able to come from it, to come to it, come to it with. Come with that which you're able to come from, to it, come to it with. But the prohibition istita'a wasn't conditioned to it. It was a what? اتركوا بالكلية, leave it in general. No, it's no buts. But when it came to doing things, the Prophet ﷺ, what did he do? علق بالاستطاعة. He conditioned it, he connected it to ability. And there are many examples like that. For example, the hadith that we've took in Bulugh al-Maram. And the hadith is the hadith of Laqit ibn Sabura, رضي الله تعالى عنه. That the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, وَبَالِغُوا فِي الْإِسْتِنْشَاقِ إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ صَائِمًا. Go far in the istinshaq, taking the water into your nose, sniffing water into your nose. The Prophet said, go far as you can, إِلَّا أَن تَكُونَ صَائِمًا, as long as you're what? As long as you're not fasting. So the command here isn't just unrestricted. The command is always conditioned and it's attached to something. And they said that here the reason why the Prophet ﷺ said don't take it to your nose fully when you're fasting is because it causes an effect towards your fasting. وهنا مصلحة بالاستنشاق فدرئت المفسدة هنا. They said there's a maslaha, which is the istinshaq. The istinshaq, is it a maslaha? Yes. But this maslaha, the harm was given precedence over it. Which is what? Our qa'ida that they said, لأن الدرء المفسدة أولى من جلب المصلحة. Rebelling the harm takes precedence over the what? Taking over the good that's going to be brought. So they said the istinshaq is a good. The istinshaq is what? It's a good. But this good, staying away from the harm, takes precedence over it. Also, another example would be if an animal came from a father and a mother, one of the two are either halal and the other one's haram. One of the animals are his parents. One is halal, can be eaten, and the other one is haram, it can't be eaten. For example, a child comes from a donkey and a horse. In English, I think they call it a mule, right? Ha. It comes from in Arabic it's called a bagal. It comes from a what? A donkey and a horse. Can you eat the horse? Yeah, a horse can be eaten. But a donkey can't be eaten. A donkey cannot be eaten, but a horse can be eaten. So here, this child, where does it come from? It comes from the one halal and one haram. What's the ruling regarding this? The scholars, they said, دَرْءُ الْمَفْسَدَةِ, rebelling the harm takes precedence over what? Bringing the good. So for that reason, فَنَحْكُمُ بِتَحْرِيمِهِ, we will give its ruling, which is haram. Which is that even if there's a halal in it, we were ordered to push the haram away first, then we were ordered to bring a good. نعم.